said, die, motherfucker. You hear the background? He said, die, motherfucker. Die, motherfucker. Die. Die, bitch. You can hate me now, but I ain't stopping. I ain't stopping for shit. Bro, this train is going till it fuck around derail, bro.
We back for another one.
It's part three. Chapter 3. Going to court with no trial. Lifestyle cruising through behind my waters. No welfare supporters. More conscious of the way we raise our daughters. Yeah. Days are shorter. Nights are colder. Feeling like life is over. These snakes strike like a cobra. The world's hot. Strike like a cobra. Fuck is we doing? We back. It's your boy. We back. And you know what time it is, bruh. You know what time it is. We back in the classroom. We had to turn up last week. We was listening to Future. We was listening to J. Cole. You know, we had to turn up. Can't be always in the classroom studying, you know what I'm saying? Gotta fall back sometime. Gotta pop bottles, you know what I mean? Gotta smoke a little bit of lie, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. Hey, for those of you who haven't checked those videos out, I reacted to Monster by Metro Boomin and Future. I reacted to the new album, I Don't Trust You by Metro Boomin and Future. Got all that shit on there. Got the Kendrick on there. Got everything on there. Timestamps under all my album reactions, by the way. It doesn't show up the chapters, so I'm clarifying that now. Including this video, there is timestamps on all of my album reactions. Just check the description, and you can pick and choose what song you want to listen to. All the chapters are there. You know what I mean? So I'm breaking this shit down for y'all boys. I'm making it easy. I'm making life super easy for y'all boys. But we fucking here. We here. Yo, let's go. Nas' third studio album. I am. Yeah. Released in April 6, 1999. We got 17 tracks on here. Damn, the album's getting longer each time. More Nas. I'm here for this shit. Let's talk about artwork. So now, it's much harder to see, but if you look very closely, you can still see the Queensbridge projects in the background. That has always been the consistent theme with these artworks, is the Queensbridge projects in the background. Except this time, he is a pharaoh. He's a sphinx. So I'm not too sure what the symbolism is of that. Maybe we'll hear something in the album that will explain that to us. But let's read the synopsis on Genius, what it says here. It says, following the commercial and critical success of his 1996 sophomore album, It Was Written, Nas returned with I Am on April 6, 1999. Quick pause. For those of you who are new to this channel, I know a lot of new viewers come to my channel from these Nas videos. I've reacted to Ether, I've reacted to Illmatic, I've reacted to It Was Written. Full, timestamps, everything there. Check the playlist. You can scroll through my channel. I don't got that many videos where it's like, you can't find that shit. Or you can just go most popular, because them bitches gonna be right at the top. But I got playlists for all of the big album reactions I've done. I got playlists for each artist I've reacted to. So just go to the playlist section, Nas reactions, everything's gonna be there. Playlist, timestamps, broken down. Right, back to this shit. Following the commercial and critical success of his 1996 sophomore album, It Was Written, Nas returned with I Am on April 6, 1999. We're getting close to my birthday now. Initially, he planned to release the album as a double album with the title I Am, the autobiography. I heard this. Someone in the comments was telling me something that there was supposed to be two albums, or I don't know if it was two albums or it was like a combined album of like he starts out as like a fetus and then he like it's his journey of him growing up into the like to who he is now. Yeah, and then apparently music was just getting leaked like crazy. And it just fucked up the whole vision. So then instead of releasing that project Instead, he decided to release this project, I Am, and then the next project we're gonna react to, which is Nostradamus. Yeah, so there's a few songs from this double album that's in this album, and then there's a few songs that are in the next album, Nostradamus. So yeah, I heard about that. Shout out to you, whoever you was. I'm gonna put your comment in the video somewhere right here. Shout out to you for letting me know about that. But the album was released as a single album after a number of songs were leaked onto the internet in MP3 format. One of his first albums to be bootlegged in this manner. Despite that setback, the album debuted number one on Billboard 200 and achieved a double platinum status with support from singles like Nas's Like, produced by DJ Premier. DJ Premier is very present in Nas's early career. And the Puff Daddy assisted Hate Me Now. The album cover continued the progression of Nas from a boy Illmatic to a man. It was written to a king. Okay, there we go. That's our answer. So that's why he's as a sphinx, because a sphinx is representative of a pharaoh, and a pharaoh is like an Egyptian king. I got it. So, oh shit. And that's so fire, because like I said before, he maintains the Queensbridge Project's translucent theme in the background, but always the image is different. So in he's a boy, which he literally is in the cover of Illmatic. Queensbridge theme, he's a boy. It was written Queensbridge theme, but he's a man. And now here we got the same Queensbridge theme, but he's true to his home. He's true to his home. He's been Queensbridge from the gate till this day, and it just showing his phases of evolution, bro. This is what we're talking about, bro. Even the artworks have value, you know what I mean? Even the artworks have, bro, the artworks are damn near rapping to you, like spitting balls damn near, like, yeah, message on that shit. So, getting into the features, as we mentioned earlier, we got Diddy on track 3, Hate Me Now. We got Scarface on Favor for a Favor, which is on track 5. I know about Scarface, I've never listened to him before, so this is gonna be something for me to get into as well. Okay, he's got Aaliyah on track 8. You Won't See Me Tonight. I love Aaliyah. I actually do listen to Aaliyah. I like listening to Aaliyah a lot. And ooh, we got DMX on track 11. That's rowdy. That's energy. Oh shit, I might be throwing chairs for that one. Nas, I Am, as fucking always. Y'all been showing mad love on these Nas reactions, so appreciate y'all boys. Here we go, chapter 3, I Am. If y'all enjoy these videos, you already know what to do. Like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're new. Welcome to the family, you feel me? Comment what else y'all want me to react to. And shit, let's waste no time, man. Track 1 is album intro, in brackets, I Am. We're here. I shoot slugs from my brain just like a rifle. Stampede the stage. Now it's my nigga doing. You know you got the bad thing. Oh, he's sampling his own songs. So that first one was Live at the Barbecue, and right now this is Halftime. From the split that I lived in hell, it ain't hard to tell. Bunch of Illmatic samples. I remember that line. In my book of rhymes, all the words past the margin. I remember that line. I had a lot to say about that one. One love. Oh, okay. So as always, Nas never fails to create the movie as intros. When you watch a movie, you watch like part 2 or part 3. And you know what's fucking crazy about this shit too? Is like, so this album came out in 1999, right? Although I guess It Was Written did come out 2 years after, so it's not like that much of a difference in gap. But you know when you release a movie and then they release the sequel way later, but they released the sequel so fucking long ago or so much later than the original movie that they gotta create like a recap at the beginning just to remind you of what happened in the first movie so you can just, you know, re-catch up. That's what this feels like. It feels like he's doing all these little samples of Illmatic songs, and he did The Message just earlier, so it was written songs as well, just to catch you back up on the story, right? And I think the lyrics that he's sampling too, don't quote me on this, but I'm just taking a guess. I think the lyrics that he's sampling too, specifically from each song, must have like significance to him being a king in this album. Right? See, here goes The Message. It was written. Street Dreams. Everybody's looking for something. If I Rule the World. Yo, I've been jamming this song, If I Rule the World. I've been jamming this shit for real. Like, it just came out last week or something, bro. This shit is so hard, bro. I love this song. With Lauryn Hill, too. Yo, Jungle. Okay. Yeah. This the third time for real. This the third time we letting them know. Track 2, New York State of Mind Part 2. Part 1, iconic track. Let's see what we got in Part 2. Oh my god, this shit's about to get serious, bro. He's about to get in his, yeah. I was literally about to say, I was just letting it play. I was literally about to say, in the first New York State of Mind, that was the song that made me just completely understand why his storytelling is just undefeated, because his storytelling on that first one was crazy. So for him to call this New York State of Mind Part 2, you're giving yourself an expectation to stand up to. Broken glass in the hallway, bloodstained floors, neighbors looking at me back and break through your doors. Lock the top lock, mama should have cuffed me to the radiator. Why not? It might have saved me later from my block. Rock cops, hookers crawling off the straw, coughing stitches in their head, thinking, and I dread thinking they be snitching. But who else could it be? Shook of D's, I'm off vans, parked in the dark. Knocks, where's your heart? Hustlers start building, come out later wearing camouflage. Switch the outfits on them. What? Can't let them figure my shit out? Wearing camouflage. Like I'm a fucking, come on, bro. They bust a uni, I jog to my building. Come out later wearing camouflage. Yeah. Sergeant and the captain. Strangle men, niggas gasping for air. Till they move no more and just stare with this. Overcrowded cribs, uncles home from bed, sisters pregnant, fathers on drugs. Mom is smoking, beds is piss infested, had eight partners growing up. Life of the struggle. Overcrowded cribs. Man. 6-7 motherfuckers sleeping in one bed, bro. One room. You know? We got a family of 7. But we got a master bedroom and a guest room. That's it. So we got motherfuckers sleeping on the floors, on the kitchen floors, on the stairs. Fuck you know about it. Overcrowded cribs. Uncles home from biz. They just did their time. Now we got even more people in the crib. Sisters pregnant. They about to bring even more kids into the world. Family's about to get even bigger. Father's on drugs. Mom's smoking. Bed's just piss infested. Stinking up. Ranking up. Had 8 partners growing up. 8 turned to 7. Shit. 7 turned to 6 niggas. Got 2 in heaven. 6 of us holding it. Now it's 5 rolling dick. The damn. 6 ones parole flip. 5 niggas went to 4 quick. When he went OT, college life converted into gang banging. 4 niggas still hanging. Years passing, slang changing. 3 of us now, 4th nigga ain't around. We all thought he was real. He did the snake shit. Shit. Fake shit. Beat his ass down. Bitch. Could have got us all wasted. What a fucking clown. All I got left in the end is 2 of my best friends. And we all going out to the death with his ends. Look how he counted that shit down. Told a story at the same time. He said he had 8. 2 of them died, knocked them down to 6. Then they got knocked down to 5 because one's parole flipped, so he's back into bars. Then they got knocked down to 4 because 5th one went to college, wanted to change his life. He is done with this. He's not trying to get involved with this shit no more. Then they went to 3 because 4th one started snitching, and now he just got 2 of his friends left. It's just him and the 2. Who are the 2? AZ and Jungle? Holding the ends down. I take a nigga dough, send him home to a shoebox. You lost that nigga, I put your dollar in the jukebox. Hear my favorite song, all these niggas sing along. All the cigarette smokes clog in my lungs. Hood rats passing their tongue, young thugs blasting their gun. We got reputations, bitches and niggas both on parole or probation. Yeah. The sick niggas got gats, army fatigues. I got my eyes glued on whoever walk in the lead. He said, shit is sick. My boys got gats. Army fatigues. These boys is worn down from war. They tired, bro. They tired. Back and forth. Hood to hood. Block spinning. Can't keep up with themselves no more. Army fatigues. Stick your ass up. Niggas will find the loot in your kicks. Bunch of triple cross niggas. Find the loot in your kicks. Motherfuckers don't keep that shit in their pockets because they know about pickpockets. They know motherfuckers be trying to loot their shit. So they keep that shit in the kicks. But we come from the same background, bro. Your strategies is known in the hood. We all do the same shit, bro. You can't hide from me. I know your shit's in your kicks. That ain't gangster. Niggas is up north with tatted tears. Your name's on the affidavit. You ratty kids. Fuck you, we run wild at NY. You can't live. Got your quiet niggas that relocated down south. Coming back to Florence. Then you got the jealous loud. He said, got your quiet boys that relocated down south, coming back to the floss. Then you got the jealous loudmouths. That's crazy. That's like a callback almost to the first New York State of Mind. Because if you remember, in the first New York State of Mind, he says, kill the body, lose the gun, head to Houston. And Houston is down south. So now in New York State of Mind part 2, he's saying, got your quiet boys that relocated down south. Down to Houston, he's calling back to that shit. What? Go to any hood that's live and make it live. A lot of niggas scheming, some real, some niggas frontin'. But I'm a big dreamer, so watch me come up with something. New York, New York, New York. Track 3 is Hate Me Now. I think it was Hate Me Now and Undying Love was the ones that people were saying were like the big songs. I guess because this one was one of the singles, right? It said that, we said that earlier. This one. And then, yeah, a lot of people were saying this song and Undying Love are the songs that you pay attention to from this album. I heard a couple people talking about Favor for a Favor as well, but I feel like they was just mentioning that because Scarface is on there. And I think Scarface just had a really good verse. But we gonna hear it. We gonna hear it. I'm hearing all this shit for the first time. Bro, I'm so fucking hyped, bro. Track 3, Hate Me Now. Let's get into it. Oh, I have heard this shit. I have heard this shit. I've never really paid attention to the lyrics though, but I have heard this shit. Turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am. Baby. It's so fitting for a King theme. He said, die, motherfucker. You hear the background? He said, die, motherfucker. Die, motherfucker. Die. Die, bitch. You can hate me now, but I ain't stopping. I ain't stopping for shit. Bro, this train is going till it fuck around derail, bro. Hate me. Hate the money I see. Clothes that I buy. Ice that I wear. Clothes that I try. Close your eyes. Yeah. Rolling sixes. Money falling. Bitches, honeys that swollen. The richest. Knots get in ya. Most critically acclaimed. Melissa. Prize winner. Ha ha ha. Most critically acclaimed, Pulitzer Prize win. He's letting them know, you can hate me. You can, please. I advise it. Look what you hating on, though. Just remember what you hate. You can hate me, but you hating on a what? A motherfucker who see the money. You hating on the clothes I'm wearing. You hating on the ice I'm... You see this shit. Flows that I try. Flows that I try is insane, given how many flows he's how much he's influenced the rap game, bro. In terms of, like, flows that exist today. To say you can hate me for flows that I try. I'm the one experimenting, but y'all motherfuckers done took this shit 30 years down the road. What you talking about? Bitches, honeys, that swollen to riches. Nas get you in your most critically acclaimed. Pulitzer Prize winner. Best storyteller. Come on, talk to them. What? That swollen to riches. Nas get in your most critically acclaimed. Pulitzer Prize winner. Best storyteller. Thug narrator. My sales rater. Model data. Big bet to a lot of you haters. Commentators. Ringside crowd. Watching my paper. Like your favorite MC. Still making some mean cast. First rapper to bring a platinum plaque back to the project. Yeah. Still want to hate? Be my guest. I suggest. Which album went platinum? Did both of them go platinum? Okay, so it was written. It was double platinum. Come on, then. Yeah, I figured it would have been that one. It Was Written was just the album. That's the album that I would imagine that would go platinum. I feel like Illmatic is for a community of people. I feel like Illmatic. No, okay. Illmatic is for a community. It's for a specific community. Whereas It Was Written is the more commercial album. I think I was saying that a lot in the reaction as well. Like, it just felt like there was a lot more commercial records on there. Damn, hold on. Sorry, he said on that interlude, he said money is power, motherfucker. I got millions of thugs on salary. He's got a whole army around him. So he has all the power he needs. And the reason he has that army is because he's got them on salary. He's got them on paycheck. Wanna hate me, then hate me. What can I do but keep getting money? Funny, I was just like you. I had to hustle. Just a quick question for anybody who knows. Did Nas ever have beef with Biggie? Because from the first albums, especially from It Was Written, when he was having those lines about like who runs the island and all that shit, like, I felt like there was certain lines where he was kind of not really attacking Biggie, but like just kind of, you know, like stepping like big bro, like I'm the one who runs this shit now. And I know that Puff Daddy or Diddy was connected with Biggie when Biggie was around. Like they was always connected with each other. It was Diddy and Biggie. So to see Diddy on Nas's track, it makes me question whether there was problems or not. So if anyone knows more about the history on that shit, please let me know in the comments below if there was any static at all or if it was just, you know, friendly competition in the rap game. Hang on me, I'm blue, but I'm the same OG. People warn me, when you on top, there's envy. Took my niggas out the hood, yeah. Put you down on us. Saying we left the hood, but can't get it out of us. My bad. Woo! Took my boys out the hood, but you doubt on us. Saying we left the hood. But we can't get it out of us. We is just, it's not that we went Hollywood. We is just hood motherfuckers living Hollywood lives. We in Hollywood now, but we still got that hood heart. That's us. That's our identity. Should I step on my shoes, give them to you? Hit my cars in my house, you can live in that too. Criticize when I broke the street. Hit my dress code, Gucci this, Fendi that. What you expect, ho? Of course, I'm double platinum now. Gucci this, Fendi that. What you expect? I'm double platinum now. I'm not young Queensbridge. I'm not the boy no more. I'm not even the man no more. I'm the king. Yeah, that's the theme right here. That's the theme. Let's go. Big name Esco took this game to a threshold. Best floor, I bet the whole US know. Try to make it whole like US. But who the hell is think? Well, you all know the answer to that. Cause niggas feel us. Right? Never. This is the epitome of motivation music right here, bro. Ever in your life, if you feel like you can't do some shit, you put this shit on right here and you're gonna do that shit. Something in you is going to unlock, bro. Yo, I gotta hit the gym with this one, bro. I might start hitting PRs like it's nobody's fucking business, bro. I'm telling you, bro. This shit got me fucking amped, bro.
I like this. I like the way this feels. Let's go.
It's a thin line between paper and hate. Friends and snakes. Now I'm
Even just something so small as Diddy saying that, I like that shit. Like, he said, I like this. I like the way that this feels. He likes the fact that motherfuckers is hating because he knows, bro. The motherfuckers hating on him, that means he's doing something right. If he was just doing the same thing that every other normal person was doing, they wouldn't be hating. But he's doing something different. He's doing something above them. I like this. These motherfuckers is my signal. I can see what they're how they're reacting to what I'm doing. That's my signal that I'm doing something right. They're not reacting like normal, as if I'm doing something regular. They're reacting differently. I like this. I like the way this feels.
I'm millions of 38. Mm. Hell on a pearly case. I was destined to come. Predicted. Blame guarding blue breath in my lungs. Making the nun. Quick and turn
wide. Hell are the pearly gates. I was destined to come. Predicted. Blame God, he blew breath in my lungs. You could take that as simple as, like, you know, God created me, right? You know, he gave me the air to breathe, to survive, to exist, right? But it's like, when you rap, you use your lungs. God blew breath in my lungs. I'm speaking, this is God's breath I'm speaking to you right now. I'm speaking some sacred shit, bro. I'm speaking some, come on, bro. And then also the whole thing of him being God's son too, right? Like,
quick and turn wives to widows. Mm. Through sad pillows, the desolate one. Took a little time to claim my spot. Chairman of the board until this game stopped. And I side with the Lord. Fighting, I'm sure they catch me with their glocks to my jaws. Mm. Tried sticking me up, but I flipped on these stuff. Instead of me, ambulances were picking them up.
Damn. Plotting, I'm sure. To catch me with their glocks to my jaws. They had me right here. Tried sticking me up. But I flipped it. Instead of me, they ambulances were picking them up.
Fury of man became a monster. On top of the world. Never falling out as real as they come. From day one forever fall.
Come on. This album is off to a fantastic start. And I say that for every Nas album. But I'm not even including anything else in hip-hop right now. When we're talking about Nas, I'm comparing what I've heard of Nas to this point. And compared to what I've heard to this point, bro, I love this shit, bro. This one is the most, I mean, we only three tracks in. First track is a fucking intro, right? So, but like, three tracks in, this one is really giving me the most aggression. Track 4 is called Small World. Let's go.
See no evil, fear no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. Bring that shit around you. You ain't got nothing to worry about. Yeah.
Bro, his beats, bro. Oh my God, bro. This shit touches the soul, bro. This shit touches the soul. Yo, this album has already got me just up, bro. Oh my God.
See no evil, fear no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. If you don't bring that shit around you, you ain't got nothing to worry about.
Just eliminate negativity. You got nothing to worry. That's facts, bro. Life lesson right there. Come on.
Yo, Carolyn from Maryland, she lady having when she Maryland, the implants, caravan, keys and dope, loving cats is key in the throat. She fuck killers in her condo, her bitch in her boat. I gave her my math, ain't nothing new to me. Blowing backs out, six pack stouts, wide fat mouth, the eagle look with a bow leg. Yo, baby said, shorty's a pro. She blow head, she push the bow red. She no fast, fast no heart, go red. Maybe she stopped to slay me. This bitch is crazy, she blew the celly up. Meet me at the telly and fuck. She knew about casting way back. We smoked the haystack, she never broke once. Blunts was a hobby, she said I knew a man pop.
Damn, never coughed once. She's smoking too much, bro. Never coughed? How?
Crazy, she blew the celly up. Meet me at the telly and fuck. Small world, one where beef could never end. At the time, at least expected, I'ma see you again. It's a small world, you get away with it now. Soon enough, it catches up to you some way, somehow. Yo,
crazy, you can't escape that shit. Bro, it's a small world. Everyone knows everyone. Everyone goes wherever you think you far away enough, you hidden, you know? You did your dirt, you handled your business, now you way over here. There's motherfuckers who know the motherfuckers who know the motherfuckers who's from here who can connect them to them to them to get you caught up, bro. Everyone knows everyone. You're never safe, bro. You always gotta be on your 10, bro. Okay, so the first verse he was talking about, I don't know what she was, a drug addict or a hooker or what. Now this verse he's talking about from Red Hook with Grimy Defy. I don't know. He's talking about one of the motherfuckers on the road. Red Hook was Grimy did 5 years. Glad to be home from Attica. Known for keeping chrome calibers. Swings, thought he was slow. Played the crib for a month. Indebted his PO. Started robbing niggas till he caught a whole kilo. He had a bunch of starving niggas. He never paid though. He's about to get caught up. It's a small world. You know? It says right here. He had a girl in Woodside, Queens. He was chilling with her. He thought he was low. Played the crib for a month and deaded his PO. You know? Deaded his PO so nobody could find him. Started robbing people till he caught a whole kilo. He had a bunch of starving motherfuckers he owed. He owed a bunch of people debt, but he never paid. Now this is where he fucked up. He thought he was low. He thought he could get away with this shit. Now let's see. His old man? Wait. Hard sign on his door. Don't knock hard. Laying with his bitch. We is rich. That's what he told her. Like he thought he, at this point, he still thinks he's cool. He's good. Played the block. Holding cracks inside the baby stroller. Here come his crazy soldier. 6 shots, it's over. A year went past. Snook went flossing fast. His old man had crossed his ass for the laws of... His old man got him. Damn. It's a small fucking world, bro. His pops. For the laws of this fast cash. Snook done did all what he did, laid low, made the money, got rich, old man came around, and now the bank is his. If you sleep, you don't know, a very small world, her beef could never end, at the time you least expected, I'ma see you again, it's a small world. This motherfucker Nas hates sleep, bro. This is the third album now, bro. He's talking against sleep, like, what goes around comes around. If you sleep, you don't know, you gotta be awake. You gotta be on your 10, bro. But I could understand it though, the lifestyle that he lived. I could understand why he's never sleeping. This beat is insane, bro. Who produced this? This is DJ Premier? Produced by Nasheem Myrick and Carlos 6 July Brody. Shout out y'all, bro. This beat is crazy. It's barbed wire, we let the slugs fly into your brain, through your skull. Another thug dive, picture your soul into that infinite black hole where many souls go because of a 4-4 blast. Snoop was one of them, so many more. Even at 50 Hall, got niggas hit up here today. Just bro. This is what Nas is good at, bro. The way he describes that. Like, I seen death. I seen thugs cry. It's bugged. Why? We let the slugs fly into your brain. This is a doorway into your brain, through your skull. Another thug dies. Pitching your soul. Pitching? Like baseball pitching? Like just chucking. We're just chucking souls into a black hole. He said into an infinite black hole where many souls go because of a 4-4 blast. What he's very simply saying is that motherfuckers get killed, motherfuckers die. Just that simple. This is the way of life. Where are we from? Motherfuckers is getting killed, but motherfuckers is dying. But the way he's saying it, bro, another thug dies, pitching your soul into that infinite black hole where many souls go because of a 4-4 blast. I'm telling you, it's the way he says this shit, bro. I promise, I'm probably gonna say that shit every single album. Y'all can't even blame me, bro. Because y'all probably feel the same way, bro. This motherfucker's different with this narration shit, bro. Death, see thugs cry, it's bugged, why? We let slugs fly, it's your brain. Through your skull, another thug dies, picture your soul into the infinite black hole, where many souls go, cause of the last, Snoop was one of them, so many more, even at Benny Hall, got niggas shit up, you let the Henny pour, for Carolyn, paid up bitch, made bitch, stayed rich, heard a bodyguard, took Snoop to guard, kept on Morasco, got me back on, and gave my blast on, at the gas station, bunch of Arabs racing, out the way. Tour spray, jump in the whip, hit the highway. You know how I say the game that I play is real tendencies where you feel your enemies. Yo, I don't wanna speak too soon. Cause it's very early in the album. I really don't wanna speak too soon. But I'm gonna say this, like, just off of what I'm hearing now, we're already starting to catch up to It Was Written. I can't lie to you. And this is my personal opinion, right? So, like, if you feel different, you're completely entitled to how you feel. But this shit is already starting to catch up to It Was Written. I'm not going to go as far as Illmatic. Illmatic was different. We're not there yet. But this shit is starting to catch up to It Was Written for me already. Oh, my God. This shit is serious. Track 5 is called, this is the one. Okay, track 5 is called Favor for a Favor, featuring Scarface. We starting with Scarface. Okay, let's go. Yo, he sounds even older than Nas. Like, in terms, I'm saying older, like from an older era than Nas. Like, the way he's rapping is, it sounds so traditional. He kind of reminds me of Freddie Gibbs a little bit. Like, okay, Nakamichi. Nakamichi is a Japanese electronic company that produces high quality audio cassette. So they're talking about their record. They ain't ready for the Nakamichi. I flip this shit like I'm Kamenichi, who is an Olympic gymnast. The first to receive a perfect 10 in women's competitions on the bars. I flip this shit like Kamenichi, cause gymnast. What we here for? Tell these niggas why we here. Yeah. The New York to Texas connection. Nothing but some real shit. Scarface is from Texas. Nothing but the New York to Texas connection. Scarface. American rapper and record producer from Houston, Texas. Okay. Got it. I'm dreaming, think I'm a wolf. Harsh realities of life. Hit me after I smoke. Money satisfied. Woo! Harsh realities of life hit me after I smoke. Yeah, he smokes and then starts getting super, super introspective. He starts seeing everything in a, in a different perspective. Harsh realities of life hit me after I smoke. Money satisfied, half of my mood. Then there's a part of me that's distant, quiet. The most dangerous side of me, I'm twisted like Dr. Death, Kevorkian, flip shit, white gun handle. Made a move to let my Houston niggas come. He said, I'm twisted like Dr. Death, Kevorkian. Dr. Jack Kevorkian has been notorious for publicly champion. Yeah, this is beyond me, bro. The champion euthanasia is the practice of ending the life of a patient to limit the patient's suffering. I'm twisted. Okay. So that's why they're calling him Dr. Death.
any nigga can get it. You wet who I want, wet it. I wet who you want, wet it. Any nigga can get it. You wet who I want, wet it.
Favor for a favor. You wet who I want, wet it. And I'll wet who you want, wet it. This that New York to Texas connection. Done. They mess with. I blow his mind, but like, I blow his mind though. Like, he said, let it. I pull these capers all the time. Like, I might be reaching with this, but he said, let it. So I'm thinking like he's leading them, but like lead, like the bullets is lead though. So like, let it. I pull these capers all the time. The ad libs is vulgar, bro. But oh, cause he said throwing up his. Oh, he finna die. He fin to die, and even Finn, he, come on, bro, he fin to die, like he finna die, like he, like it's, like you just shortening that shit. But Finn is like end, like your end. He fin to die. Throwing up his own blood, repping for his family, but throwing up his own blood. And then that's why the ad libs in the background. Oh my God, bro. I tell these niggas, let's go. And then we better ride. And they finna die. Throwing up his own blood with a slug in his motherfucking mug. I ain't decided love. So money ain't no good. Sticking out a favor. Until I need a favor. I kill a color, super than told. How we bury beef for the rose. To his wake, we send a reef that explodes. Beneath us, see with the reaper. They sleep eyes closed. God damn, bro. What the fuck? A killer code, secret untold. How we bury beef with a rose. They put like flowers on your grave and shit. How we bury beef with a rose. To his wake, we send a wreath that explodes. What? Bro, ruthless. No mercy. Like, even after you done. The flowers gon' boom your shit, bro. What? We said a wreath that I'm full froze, ready, five masks, five Mercedes. Attack them like Freddy, then we toastin' over spaghetti. I share it with your drama. Five fofos ready, five masks, five machetes. Attack them like Freddy, cause Freddy's got the machete and yeah. Five Mercedes, attack them like Freddy, then we toastin' over spaghetti. I share it with your drama, you share with mine. That's how we killin' two birds at the same. Attack him like Freddy. Hold on, sorry. Attack him like Freddy. Then we toastin' over spaghetti is some Michael Corleone ass lyrics, bro. I could just imagine that shit. The big banquet hall in the fat ass mansion that they probably bought 50% with drug money too. These motherfuckers is toasting some rosé in black suits. Got the fucking little rose in the collar pocket. In the little, you know what I mean? Yeah, we did the job today. And that motherfucker is buried, flattened, face squashed on the pavement. What are we talking about, bro? That's how we killin' two birds at the same time. Send my enemy's ear. I send your enemy's finger with a pinky ring. As is a present, my nigga. Either way, but either spray. Fuck with face you bring. He gave him a bonus. Oh my God, he gave him a bonus. Send my enemy's ear. I'll send your enemy's finger. I'll send this guy. But I'll send this guy as well. Pinky ring. Oh, pinky ring, not pinky. Pinky ring. That's, because it's a present, because it's like the jewels, right? Yeah. You bring war. Either you feel these bullets or the Texas chainsaw. Not for popularity reasons, but for the love of- this shit must have rode the murder rate like a motherfucker, bro. Fuck. This shit is crazy. They must have been playing this all through the fucking 99s, bro. 2000s. Every time an assault happens, you run this shit right here, bro. I wet who you want, wet it. Any nigga can get it. I wet who you want, wet it. You wet who I want, wet it. Any nigga can get it. Track 6 is called We Will Survive. Let's go.
to my dogs, wherever you are. What up, big? You know shit is rough after you slid. You in God's hands now. Keep your place on me, kid. Ain't nothing changed still.
Oh, shit. Okay, then maybe this might answer my question, because he's speaking to Big, and this based on how he's talking, this must be after Big passed.
Came to my hood, we was broke. I wonder if we stayed that way, would there have been gun smoke still on the block around things numb from coke? I guess so.
See, but then he says, I wonder if we stayed that way, would there have been gun smoke? I don't know, man. Y'all gotta let me know. Y'all gotta fill me in on the history. Y'all gotta fill me in on the history with this shit, because I'm not too sure. This is well before my time, bro. The whole thing with Pac and Biggie and Nas and them boys. This is before my time. So those of you who know, let me know.
Now competition is none, now that you're gone, and these niggas are wrong. Using your name in vain, and they claim to be New York's king. It ain't about that. It's more.
Okay, actually, maybe. I don't know. I keep going back and forth, but maybe this is answering my question. Because he said, it used to be fun making records to see your response. So maybe it was just friendly competition. But now competition is none, now that you're gone.
Wait, I wouldn't stay so long with so much to say. I had to put it in writing to keep me in Brooklyn from fighting. Mm. Telling me to pay my respects and move to the side. But I probably wouldn't have got off my knees to let people vibe. You can't kill nothing that's ready to die. You was like God to us in the form of a...
Tough. Tough. You can't kill nothing that's ready to die. You is like God to us in the form of Allah. Ready to die. I know ready to die is like, that's Biggie's big, big album is ready to die. You can't kill nothing that's ready to die. And that shit is tough too, because although Biggie has passed away, rest in peace, his spirit lives on forever. So, and he's ready to die. Like he already's accepted his fate will live on in your presence. Oh, wow.
And use teeth to bite off beer tops and pour out a little liquor. He was more than just the wildest nigga.
Pour out, is that a song? A reference to pour out a little liquor and so many tears by Tupac. Yeah. Dear Pac, thug shed tears, shed. Every thug sheds a teardrop. And use teeth to bite off beer tops and pour out a little liquor. Wow. Verse 1 for Big, verse 2 for Pot. Crazy.
The East and West Coast, the same shit is going on.
Yeah.
The industry be talking, offending me often. They don't believe you dead, want to see you in your coffin. I can relate, shootouts and court dates, all eyes on you. Niggas in your face, and they...
Yo, y'all seen... I mean, this is news from a couple months ago. But y'all seen that... Pac's killer was caught. I forgot who it was. I remember I watched a documentary about Tupac, and from that documentary I always used to think it was Orlando Jackson who killed him, but it wasn't. It was I don't remember his name. I think it was like Keith or something like that. It was one of the main figures who played a role in that whole beef. We're not here for that right now, but I just wanted to bring that up, like, because he mentioned that they don't believe you dead. They want to see you in your coffin. And like until just a few months ago, like that's how people was still thinking. Like to this day.
I can relate. Shootouts and court dates, all eyes on you. Niggas in your face, invading your space. You act about betraying your place. How would I hold up?
All eyes on you, all eyes on me. That's Tupac shit. And he named a couple of his songs earlier as well.
Eyes on you, niggas in your face, invading your space. You act about betraying your place. How would I hold up? How long would I ride before I fold up? How did you know through your rhymes it was your time to go? You predicted it in every line, all in your flow. They could never be.
I heard about that. I haven't listened to much Tupac either. But I heard that, like, Tupac predicted his own death. He predicted how that shit was gonna happen.
Think about how us real niggas would be if we united, a nation of thugs who could fight it. You was caught in a wild homicide, or were you crucified like the son of God? When Lucifer lied and make the...
See? You was caught in a wild homicide, or were you crucified like the son of God when Lucifer lied? I like that he said when you crucified, because I've mentioned this before on previous videos. In the Machiavelli cover art, he was on a cross. So like...
MC is nice, will you return to us like the resurrection of Christ?
Still somehow I... Bro, I'm telling you, bro, the way that these guys play with like how they use God like so frequently in their raps. Like they just associate God. Bro, they do it the right way, bro. It really puts them on like a upper pedestal. Like when you're talking about God, that could, if you could say one thing wrong and what you're saying could instantly just been taken as like blasphemy. Like you're talking crazy. You're thinking above yourself. Yeah. You're thinking too much of yourself. But I don't know, something about like the way these rappers talk about God and on the cross, and bro, they set themselves in like a, how do I say, there's like a room of the elite that's above all this hip hop shit. And these motherfuckers live in that room. It's like different levels.
The drugs, put an end to the music business of soul. Should I put out the end of right now and write down a plan and pursue my dream? Turn my life around because I'm bound for the movie screen. Cuties are screen. I need an extra Uzi riding through my own hooded queens and be the ones you always knew.
I need an extra Uzi riding through my... It's dangerous for me too. It's even more dangerous now that I'm a superstar. I need an extra Uzi. That's my security right there, man.
It's looking good. Hip hop took it to billions. I knew we would. A lot of ups and downs in the game. Could lose or gain a couple pounds trying to maintain. One day you hear, the next you not. When you around niggas, check them out. Some is about it. Most individuals plot some running spots. Some choose to stay to themselves while others have no cares to stay in jail. More than 50% of us ending up with holes through the chest, through the head, through the gut. It shows the future for us.
Man's laying down statistics, demographics on your ass. Bro, he's saying some of us run to spots. Some of us choose to stay to themselves. Others have no cares and stay in jail. More than 50% of us end up with holes through our chest, through the head, through the gut. It's show, bro. He's throwing demographics on your ass, bro.
Young shooters and old killers who become rich as dope dealers. Nothing left for us but hoop dreams and hood tournaments. Thug coaches with stuff sitting on a bench, either that or rap. We want the fast way out of this trap.
Oh, again, the description. Nothing left for us but hoop dreams or hood tournaments. Hood tournaments is insane, bro. This is like a round robin. This is knockout stage. It's shootouts, bro. You versus me. Whoever's team is all gone and dead, then them boys get the point. Thug coaches, the leaders of the gangs is subs sitting on the bench. Like, we sending these hitters out today, but we sending them boys out tomorrow. Like, what, bro? And I like how he said nothing left for us but hoop dreams. I like how he included the hoop dreams, because then now it makes you think, like, hood tournaments, thug coaches, subs sitting on the bench gives you kind of like a, it goes with the hoop dreams, because coaches, tournaments, and subs on the bench, this, right, it's like a basketball type of scheme. But then, oh yeah, man, Nas is going crazy, bro. Nas is going fucking crazy, bro. Like, these last couple songs have been a little bit less on the aggression. I'm saying last couple. No, it's really just that one. It's just really just We Will Survive. But that song was very, very meaningful. Like, that was a very meaningful, impactful, it felt like, song. Like, he's giving people a way to feel after the passing of Biggie and Tupac. And he's saying, we will survive in your memory. Like, we will hold up your legacy, right? For Biggie, it's like, I'm going to hold up New York for you. And then for Pac, like, he's saying his gods. He was referring to them as his gods. We holding this shit down for y'all. All right, track 7 is called Ghetto Prisoners.
Some of y'all don't live it all. Get yours, baby. Get yours, baby.
You know, in my head, I just have a little bit more appreciation for these beats, because these beats, they sound so tough. And then also, I know that the technology that was used to produce beats in this time was so different. They wasn't using the computers like that. They had the proper, like, the scratch, the table, the mixers. It wasn't as easy as just click and drag. Like, you had to really come up with this sound. Like, you had to test different loops. You had to test different sounds. You had to play around with shit to even find what you're looking for and make it sit. Like, So, like, to hear how this beat sounds, and then the beats I'm hearing on this album are harder than a lot of the beats you hear today. So, like, it's just, I just have respect in my heart, like, hearing this shit. Every time I hear the beat and the beat sounds hard, I just feel that shit. Like, that shit is, that there was hard work put in making what I'm hearing right now. Damn. He said, I'm like a farmer planting words. People are seeds. Planting words. The shit that I speak is birthing people's whole, like, identities. Like, people is moving off of my lyrics. I'm here planting words. People are seeds. My truth is the soil that's helping them grow. Like, help you grow like trees. What? May the children come in all colors, change like leaves. Like, his influence is starting to get global. So now, like, different parts of the world, different races are getting tapped in to his message, are following his message. But hold before you one of those prophetic, oh my God, bro. But the farmers, seeds, soil, trees, colors change of the leaves. Like, year round he's doing this shit, bro. But then all races as well, because he's saying all colors, because the, come on, bro. That was deep. He said, we God's children, habitats in tall buildings, in the apartments, you know, in these complexes. Rats crawl in filthy hallways. Shit staying with piss and shit and all type of shit. Rats crawl in these filthy, dirty hallways. Incinerators. Sinners who faithless. Still this hope, pray is answered. What's a wicked nation? One with blind men not taking charge of the situation, not making a change. That's a, bro. One with blind men, though, like, what's a wicked nation? The nation is already wicked. The nation is fucked up. The only way shit's gonna get better is if someone takes charge and changes shit. But if everyone is blind to the situation, nothing's gonna change and it will remain wicked. At least if you start working on change, you can say it's getting better. But if it's just staying like as hell, it's gonna remain hell forever. Luckily, I was put on one of the ships that made it through strong currents and winds that left the other stranded. The sink in the Atlantic, Satan takes the planet. Not to get too religious, but who decides when if your life is finished? I'm getting it now, ghetto prisoners as well. Like, it's deeper than just being in prison, whatever, right? Ghetto, they're trapped in this lifestyle. This shit is a cycle. This shit has been repeated by Nas so many times. This lifestyle is a cycle. You know, you kill, then they get revenge, then you get revenge, then they get revenge, then motherfuckers have offspring, then they grow up in the same shit, and then it's a never-ending cycle. He said it earlier, the wicked world. A wicked world is a world where nobody tries to make a change, where nobody tries to make a difference. They're prisoners to this lifestyle, to this ghetto lifestyle. And this shit is not going to ever get better if no one steps in to free them. Like, may we break away from these chains abroad. Like, bro, everything has meaning to this shit, bro. Nothing is single layered. Everything is at least two or three layers, right? You wanna buy time? I'm the seller of minutes. I give you every second, no price. If I sold lies, the truth is time.
ways for none of you. And then you can't wait for the date to snatch the ground right from under you. Small visions of better life. If Cheddar was right, look in the mind of young ones ahead of their time. The future reduced the rate of those very young. Life is every man's kingdom, a dying man's past. And a newborn, first time to be here at last. It shouldn't have to grow up fast. It's up our pain. Hustling harder than the generations here before he came. Going through the same bullshit as our fathers.
It's a cycle, bro. This is what I'm saying. This shit is a cycle. This shit is unending. This shit is never ending. This shit will never go away until someone steps away and makes a change. These guys is prisoners to this lifestyle. I'm gonna just let this shit flow right in. I'm not even gonna do too much talking, bro. Cause you already know how it is, bro. Haven't missed a beat yet. Yo, since the beginning of me hearing Nas, I'm telling you, bro, this guy has not missed a beat. There might have been low ends. There might have been lows, for sure. But even the lows are to a complete minimum. Nothing on this album, though. Nothing on this album. I feel like, I felt like there was a few lows on It Was Written. But nothing not worth paying attention to. But it's just all highs, though. For the most part, it's like a roller coaster that just stay up, bro. This should come down every 30 tracks that Nas released. This should come down for one little 5-second drop. Then that should go right back up. Bro, this guy's undefeated to this point. Next track. Okay. I'm actually excited for this one, bro. I'm a fan of chill music, bro. I'm a fan of chill, laid-back music. The next song, track 8, is called You Won't See Me Tonight, featuring Aaliyah, produced by Timbaland.
I'm the most wanted baby father, save the drama, we toast when I wanna die.
Yo, y'all let me know, am I talking out my ass, or did Aaliyah and Nas ever have a relationship? I don't know why, for some reason, that feels like something I've seen, but I might be talking completely out my ass, bro. Y'all let me know, did Nas and Aaliyah ever have a relationship?
Can't forget how I met you. You thought I was a boxer. Prince not seen, but I'm the monster. Now I'm cruising when I got you. You riding with
me. Oh my god, she mistook him. He said his name was Nas. And then she thought he was Prince Nasib. But he's different. I'm a monster. I'm not a boxer. I take motherfuckers down in a different way. Nas from Queens.
Call back all my numbers. Star 690. Check my car for rubbers, but quit trying.
I love Aaliyah, bro. Her voice is just beautiful. Timberland boots for girls with the tree stump. They have the little tree on the Timberland logo as well. That's tough. I like how he had kind of like a, it wasn't really interactive, but it almost felt like that. Like he said, you can hang with a young man who's doing his thing, speak up. I want to know if you can keep up. Like he's like, we like, you can, it feels like you're there at the conversation, like you're hearing him. You feel, he followed that shit up, said speak up.
Tell your friends you in love with Nas, not his money. And I prove I'm a man of my word. Landed you first, iceberg. Everything on this planet Earth, a woman desires. You make a good wife to most men. I know I got you open, but you just my close friend.
Ooh. I know I got you open, but you just my close friend. But then close is like close, open close. Timberland went crazy on the beat, of course. Crazy. All right, We're gonna take a little halftime break right here. Talk about how I feel so far. So I mean, I've been giving my thoughts after every track, but what do we listen to? New York State of Mind Part 2, Elite Storytelling, Hate Me Now, Straight Aggression, Small World was even that one was straight aggression. Favor for Favor was straight aggression. We Will Survive and Ghetto Prisoners was very meaningful song. You Won't See Me Tonight is like, that's like the ride song. You ride to that shit. Bro, so far, this album has been, I can't lie, bro. Hold on, I need to make sure I know what I'm talking about. Let me go back and look at the It Was Written track list. Because I'm seriously starting to feel, I'm feeling like this one is better than It Was Written for me. You got The Message, Street Dreams, I Gave You Power, Watch Them Boys, Take It in Blood, Nas is Coming. I mean, we still have half the album left, right? So things can change. I'm gonna say it, fuck it, bro. At this point of the album, I feel like I Am is better than It Was Written. I think my ranking would be Illmatic, I Am, and then It Was Written third right now. Now, these last, what do we got? Like nine tracks? These last nine tracks could change that. And It Was Written could find its place back in second. But right now, that's how I feel, man. That's how I feel. We gonna move straight forward though, bro. Track 9 is called I Want to Talk to You. Who does Nas want to talk to? Let's see. Okay. 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 And you know how Nas raps? He's going to speak to them directly. He's going to speak to them directly. He's got a message. Step up to the White House, let me in. It's my reason for being, I'm your next of kin. Every built this motherfucker. You wanna kill me, cause my hunger, Mr. America, young black niggas, what ya? I wanna talk to the man, understand, understand this motherfucker, G back in my head. Black, but the architects of the Pentagon from Egypt. Government secret, the 99 to 2G computer shut down. What now? Extinction on Earth, human cut down, niggas play with the 99 to 2G computer shut down? Leading up to the year 2000, many experts in the world of computers thought that computers would stop working at midnight on December 31st, 1999, due to computers using only two digits to represent the year. Oh, okay, so instead of saying 1985, it just said 85. Oh, okay, I get what he's saying, like the version. So like, the computer was an 85 computer, the computer was an 86 computer. Then you go to 99. Then after 99, that shit will go back to zero. Like, it's, they thought it was going to just be 00. Like, it would just be, that shit would be, oh, okay, I get it. Computer shutdown. What now? Extension on Earth. Human cutdown. They thought the world, bro, it took so little for motherfuckers to think the world was going to end. Bro, a computer shutdown. He's talking to them because they're living luxury. They're living luxury, but these government and congressmen, a lot of them, they came up silver spoon fed. They don't understand what Nas's people is going through. They don't understand what people in these type of environments is going through, but they just shameless to lock them up and throw them in cages and, you know, gun them down and get rid of them. Like, it's very easy for them to call them a problem, but they don't understand why they is the way they is. So Nas is speaking to them. I want to talk to you. He's speaking to them. He's letting them know, like, this is what we're going through. You don't understand. Let me paint the picture. Who better than Nas to paint the picture of a scenario for somebody, bro? Forget them, like, understand this, like, shh. Y'all combining all the countries. We gonna do the same. The United Nations, right? Combine all the cliques to make one gang. Like, y'all wanna send this? We can do the same shit too. Y'all wanna combine allied forces, whatever. We can do the same shit too.
For the world to blow up, before you hear this, rewind this. 4 minutes before we timeless. Let y'all niggas bang my shit before Saddam hits. And now Saddamas tell us what time it is. The news got it all confused. Lying to the public. They eyes watching. Stay wise and move above it.
He's speaking about... Okay, I've been saying Nostradamus this whole time. It's Nostradamus. He's speaking about the perspective right now. Let Nostradamus tell us what time it is.
Water floods predicted. Hurricane twisted. It's all signs of the Armageddon. 360s. People versus the system. Politics versus religion. Holy war. Muslim versus Christian. Niggas in hot places. They don't got the balls for this. People in power sit back and watch them slaughter us.
Yeah, see? Look, this, look how he's... Bro, he's explaining in all the different ways how the world is just crashing. Water floods predicted. Hurricanes, twisters. It's all signs of an Armageddon. It's chaos over here. 360s. People reverse the system. Politics versus religion. Holy war. Muslims versus, like, religions is going against each other. Politics is going against religion. Politics is going against each other. Plus, you got natural disasters. And you got the gang situation. Bro, chaos. And then these guys is up here watching this shit from afar, acting like it's beneath them, when they is the one who had the power to do something to make shit different. Like,
people in power sit back and watch them slaughter us. Mr. President, I assume it was negligence, but your streets are upside down. I'm here to represent the mayor, to the governor, to the motherfucking president.
Bro, he almost sounds like a full-on news reporter. Like, Nas is damn near sounding like an alternative to watching the news. Like, you can watch the news or you can just listen to Nas and just be in loop with what's going on in the current time of your era.
Can I talk to you, Mr. President? You know what I'm saying? Niggas trying to get with the computers, man. You know what I'm saying? We ain't John Henry banging down a fucking cave fighting against a machine, nigga. We want to be part of establishment, nigga. That's what we stepping up for.
Track 10 is called Dr. Knockboot. I was reading about this while this outro was playing. Knocking boots is a slang for fucking, pretty much. So it's gonna be a sex song. Let's get into it, Nas. Let's see what you gotta say. Oh my god, even the beat, bro. This bouncy ass. Yeah. Let's go.
Yeah, when it comes to sex advice, I'm the one to call if you're a virgin with blue balls or you tear down walls. Not Dr. Wu, call me Dr. Knockboot. Pipped out hats, rock fashionable suits. And oh, take the pussy if she fighting, cause you saw what happened to Tupac and Mike Tyson. Especially if you're lost, some hoes is trying to get you on the rape charge. Have you serving your life? Yo, get a yes, come.
Okay, I wanna just pinpoint a very small detail. I like how the guys is telling you the don'ts and the girls is telling you the do's. Cause if you pleasing the girl, she gonna want you to do all type of shit, right? Y'all already in the moment. Y'all not really thinking at this point. So just do whatever, right? Do whatever. Also, in the situation that Nas is in, there's a lot of girls who trying to set you up, who trying to get you caught up in a situation, right? So They gonna let everything slide, but there's a reason behind it. But your guys who actually have your back is gonna tell you the don'ts. So I like, even it's just small things like that, but I like that the guys is telling you the don'ts and the girls is telling you the do's. Like, he has, yeah, that's just hard.
See, if she fighting, cause you saw what happened to Tupac and Mike Tyson, especially if you lost, some hoes is trying to get you on the rape charge, have you serving your life.
Real.
Get a yes confirmation before penetration, you wind up in a police station. No, get with no young bitch and hit it. She's PG-13, you rated R, she not permitted. No. Yo, no, lie about the cars you got. Oh, you
man, spitting real game right here, bro. Listen, pay attention. Bro, get your notebooks out, bro. He's spitting straight game.
P with fly shorty, PYT. Yo, yo, lie about the cars you got. Oh, you hate with crying when you barge your
watch.
Yo, play your game right. If the G's tight, then you can fuck shorty the same night. Yo, yo, eat the pussy the first night. Make a bless you, we call that shit kazoom type. Set the move right.
make a bless you. We call that shit Gesundheit, cause bless you, Gesundheit.
Set the mood right, Bailey's with ice. I come with the to make everything.
Bailey's with ice? Set the mood for real. Get the lights on too, fuck.
Set the mood right, Bailey's with ice. A cup of thug passion to make everything right.
Thug passion is crazy.
When you come fast like FedEx and bus too quick. Hope you're listening. Turn up your transistor ring. High 97, kiss a femme, a BLS. With your hand up a dress. Chilling with your girl while you think about your.
But he's even, he's breaking it down to the radio station. He's letting you know what radio station to play, bro. Like, Hot 97, put that shit up while you get him. Yeah, he's letting you know what to play. He's giving you the whole nine, bro.
Not too easy, not too complex. I break it down how to address the opposite sex. Problems or questions, I can answer them best. Sign it off, Dr. Napu, at your request. Peace.
That's tough that he referred to himself as Dr. Knockboot as well. Like that's what a doctor does, right? They save you. They save you in the respect of your health. So Dr. Knockboot is the doctor of sex. So he's here to save you in terms of your sex life. He's trying to, you got issues that you need to fix. So you come to Dr. Knockboot and he's going to help you fix those problems. That shit is hard, bro.
Rest havens.
That's a funny ass song, but I love the concept though. That's probably the quickest Nas song I've seen. 2 minutes, 25 seconds.
Just sit tight.
Track 11 is called Life is What You Make It. I'm not even pausing. Straight into this shit.
Yo. Ill Will. Rough Riders.
Oh shit, this is the song featuring DMX. Okay. Oh, Rough Riders. Yeah, that's Rough Riders. Okay. I'm running for White House. My boys control Senate. Pipe seats, Jeeps tinted. That's tough. That's tough. That's like a little scheme right there. I'm running for White House, so I'm the president. My boys control the Senate because the senator is like next up to the president. We got pipe seats, Jeeps tinted because the president ride around in the all black tinted windows. Mad Lewinsky chicks, some kinky shit because, you know, Monica Lewinsky was fucking with the president, had an affair with the president. But they is also part of his government.
Thought it was beat. He looked familiar, ready to blast. Nigga gave me dap, said I'm failure. Can't believe how my life changed. From the hood, the first time of my life, I can say I did the right thing. Life is what you make it, nigga. I'ma make it. No matter what it takes, my nigga, we gon' take it. Life is what you make it, nigga. I'ma make it. No matter what it takes, my nigga, we gon' take it. You make it.
Ah, let's go.
No matter what it takes, my nigga, we gon' take it. Everyday shit around the way shit got me stressed. So I keep on the vest in case a nigga wanna test. Yeah. No time for games because I'm all grown up. You wanna joke, nigga? Laugh when you get thrown up. See how funny it is when your kids ain't got no bar.
You wanna... I had no time for games because I'm all grown up. You want a joke? You can laugh when you get blown up. Then the joke is there.
Didn't think it was right. You should have checked it yourself. Too short to get caught up in some dumb shit. Wake up one day, 40 years old. Off the bomb shit. Time flew by. You were too fly to see the light. Every day it's getting darker. Then it comes at night.
Damn, that's crazy. He said life is too short to get caught up on some dumb shit. You wake up one day, 40 years old on some bum shit. Time flew by, you was too fly to see the light.
You was too fly
but to see the light.
Every day it's getting darker, then it comes at night. Now what?
That's crazy. That's insane. You was too fly to see the light. Every day it's getting darker, then comes the night. Because every day past is in your life, you getting closer to death. So every day getting darker and darker, then comes the night. Tough. Yeah. Cause life is what you make it. Oh my god, bro.
No matter what it takes, my nigga, we gon' take it. Life is what you make it, nigga. I'ma make it. No matter what it takes, my nigga, we gon' take it. Gotta pay just for living. Tax life is a business. If you catch a bad deal, watch your life diminish. Deals made by God and the devil, and we in it. Pause in a game, kick a play to take
the The message is crazy, bro. Like, don't waste time. Don't waste time just sitting around. Like, don't. Life is what you make it. But you gotta make that shit, though. It don't just come to you. You gotta create that shit yourself. You gotta start working from today. You gotta start working from early, from 18, 19, 20. You gotta start working so that when you 30, you up. But you're not gonna just be up because you older. You gotta make that shit happen.
Strap up and hold on. Hope for the best. Prepare for the worst. No fears or nothing on earth. No tears if I'm dumped in a hearse. I won't be the first nor the last, nigga. Let's get this cash, nigga. Life is what you make it, nigga. I'ma make it no matter what it takes, my nigga. We gon' take it.
Yo, I definitely gotta say, this album has had the most relatable tracks, I feel like. Like, there's been a lot of tracks that, like, people could use as models, bro. Nas was already nice with it, but, like, he's getting really, really crafty with this, with making songs relatable. Like, bro, this album has definitely had the most aggression out of all of them so far. 100%. And this album has had, for me, the most relatable tracks. Like, tracks about day-to-day life. Track 12 is called Big Things. Let's go.
Get yours, nigga, cause I'm gonna get mine.
Straight into it.
Everybody assigned. Get yours, I spray nines. I say this one time, the last time, I swear to y'all. I put where the dope fiends is at. They kill us, crawl, the snitches call police. All these niggas in the streets and shooting niggas, cold blood. Just kill them, so what? With 4 pounds, go nuts. Better slow up, before you get that ass on up. Nigga, never gonna
run. Flow is insane. Flow is insane. Already, just off of the first 30 seconds, bro. Flow is the most insane I've heard out of this entire album. Flow is crazy. Yo, and I love how Nas, he paints the whole picture. Like, whenever someone comes from a background like this, they only talk about the killers and the hoodlums. They only talk about the guys, right? No one ever talks about the snitches, but Nas, he always mentions the whole story. Like, yes, where we come from is killers, murderers, hoodlums, drug dealers, dope fiends, this and that, right? But then there's also the snitches. There's the opposite side too. He always talks about both sides. He encapsulates the entire environment. I love that shit, bro. Like, it gives like a transparency almost to what he's talking about. And it makes it better. It makes it a lot easier for people who don't come from an environment like that, who are just listening to try and learn and understand. It helps them understand better.
Like
marijuana.
Snuffing niggas and faces and starting drama and shooting niggas. Cold blood. Just kill them. So what?
Yeah.
4 pounds,
just kill them. So what? This is the way of life. So what? Kill them. Move on.
Nigga never gonna grow up. Trigger the head, but they know you gonna throw up.
Crazy. Flow is crazy. Big things. Tired of talking small talk because I'm into big things. Tired of just chopping it up and talking about nothing. I'm trying to talk about business, talking about money because I'm up there now. But small talk, big things.
Got the style on my phone for you. Can I make something wild like a dope for you? Flow for you? Make it my coastal. Take it to heights that some of y'all can't come close to. Some of y'all wanna talk like hoes, worse than bitches. And when y'all niggas see me blow, better hurt like stitches. No competition, I stop it.
But it almost doesn't even sound like Nas. I'm sorry for pausing over and over, but like, I can't get over how fast he's rapping and how smooth he's keeping it. He hasn't rapped like this till this point. Like, this fast, he hasn't rapped like this till this point. So it almost doesn't even sound like Nas. It sounds like almost like somebody else is rapping.
I go past y'all. I got the glass jaw. And when I hit it, admit it, you're on your ass, y'all. Crossing me is like shooting yourself. When it blows so fast, now do yourself.
Crossing me is like shooting yourself? Like, it's suicide. You fucking with the wrong one. I wasn't made to be tested. What are we talking about, bro?
We're on the same team. You don't want to pass the ball. Chucking gun up the dome. You want to score when you really don't want the ball. I put you on.
Ooh, he said, we on the same team. You don't want to pass the ball. Chuck and gunning for dough. You want to score, but you don't even know how to ball for real. I put you on. It was me who introduced you to your wealth. Like,
see, Mac is a flip staff in a pack heat.
run laps like a pro athlete. I've done that. From my experience, stop here, relentless. Take one time, just hear my sentence. I'ma tell you what's fair and what can stop you from making a meal. You can prevent this. When niggas don't see eye to eye to you, lie to you. Wanna get high with you? Wanna eat food off your labor and take food off your table?
Damn.
They don't see your vision. Don't understand your mission. It's to make history. Why you here? How long you plan on living?
I'm playing the long game. These motherfuckers want to make quick money. They don't see eye to eye with you. They lie to you. But they want to get high with you, though. They want to eat food off your label. They want to take food off your table. Bro, they want to make that quick dough. They fucking with you because you up. But they don't understand why you really doing this shit. You're not doing this shit for any of this. This shit is just perks. You doing this shit to make a legacy, to make history. I'm at a new level now. I'm at a new status. Can't fuck with y'all boys no more. Y'all doing this chump change activity, can't fuck with y'all boys no more. I'm up here now. Okay, next track, track 13, is called Nas Is Like. This was the other single. I was saying it's Undying Love, but Undying Love is just another song that people was telling me to check out. Nas Is Like is the second single. So, let's hear this shit.
Freedom of jail, clips inserted. A baby's being born, same time a man is murdered. The beginning and end, as far as rap goes, only natural. I explain.
This is what they sampled at the beginning of Let Nas Down. This is what they sampled at the beginning. I already explained how I interpreted this before. I'm not even explaining this shit. Y'all go check out my Nas's or Let Nas Down remix reaction. I explained my interpretation of this shit. This shit is crazy, bro. Freedom of jail, clips inserted. A baby's being born, same time a man is murdered, beginning and end.
I spent time in the game, kept my mind on fame. Saw things shoot up. Saw my close friend shot, flatline of my same. That depends, carry Mac 10s to practice my aim on rooftops.
Did J. Cole sample this? I feel like J. Cole sampled this shit. Cause it sounds like something I might have heard on like a Forest Hills Drive or like maybe even going back to like the mixtapes. Let me know. Any of you who listen to J. Cole avidly, let me know if J. Cole sampled this shit. I feel like he did. And I'm not talking about the verse. I know he sampled the first part of the verse. I'm talking about the beat. Like, the beat sounds like something I've heard on a J. Cole track before.
On rooftops, tape CD covers the trees. Line a battle up with your weak pitching and squeeze. Sheet scriptures for lost souls in the crossroads. To the corner thugs hustling for cars that cross dough. To the big dogs living large, taking it light. Push a big toy, getting nice, join your life. I'm not sick like the devil. I'm a rebel. My poetry's deep, I never felt. Not sick, not sick. Half man, half amazing.
Now, this shit is giving me Illmatic vibes. Like the scratch, bringing me back.
Earth, wind, and fire, rims and tires, bulletproof glass inside is the brother's driver. Planets in orbit, line them up with the stars. Tablet cards, you can see the Pharaoh Nas.
Nas is like half man, half amazing.
Earth, wind, and fire, rims and tires, bulletproof glass inside is the brother's driver. Seiko to Rolex, owning acres from the projects with no chips to large cake though. Now I'm skimming fellatio, siete zeros, bet my nine spin for the pesos.
Siete zeros, that's $1 million. What are we talking about? That's $10 million, I'm tripping. Seven zeros is 10 million, that's not 1 million.
Some are born when I rise, thug or die. Making choices that determine my future under the sky. To rob, steal, or kill, I'm wondering why. It's a dirty game. Is any man worthy of fame? My success to you, even if you wish me the opposite. Sooner or later, we'll all see who the prophet is.
My success to you, even if you wish me the opposite. Sooner or later, we'll all see who the prophet is.
Sex to a nympho, but not the sweet. I'm like beef, busting heat through your window. I'm like a street sweeper, green leaf reaper. Like Greeks and Egypt, learning something deep from their teachers. I'm like crime, like your nine. The man you would die for.
Like Greeks in Egypt learning something deep from their teachers? He's had a lot of references to this Egyptian theme, especially in this song. He referred to himself as a pharaoh. He's saying here the Greeks from Egypt learning something deep from their teachers. And also, I wanted to mention this earlier as well. A few of the beats in the earlier songs had like very Arabian Egyptian type of tones to them. I don't know if y'all noticed that shit, but like I was looking at the artwork and it just kind of hit me, like some of these beats have very Egyptian themes, and that must have been thought out.
I'm like the whole lot of loot. I'm like
Swiss money, corporate accounts from a rich company. I'm like ecstasy for ladies.
I'm like a whole lot of loot. I'm like Chris Money. Corporate accounts from a rich company. That's a whole lot of loot, bro.
I'm like all races combined in one man. Like the 99 summer jam. Bulletproof, I'm a man. I'm like being locked down around new faces. And none of them fam. I'm the feeling of a millionaire spending 100 grand. I'm a poor man's dream. A thug poet. What I'm like, you're playing in your system every night now.
I kind of got that from what he was saying as well. Like he said, y'all know what I'm like. Y'all play it in your system every night. He made a couple references referring to himself as like he's the message. Like he's everyday life. He's people's regular. Like, okay, let's go all the way back. Top of verse 3. He started the verse like sex to a nympho. A nympho is kind of like, I don't know how to describe a nympho, but they fuck a lot. Like, that's like kind of their thing. Like a porn star, damn near. I'm like crime, like your non. Like, literally the utilization of the non is for crime. That's everyday life. I'm like a whole lot of loot, like crisp money. Corporate accounts from a rich company is like, corporate accounts from a rich company is continuously funneling money and like loot, how they would refer to it. Ecstasy for ladies, that's the ladies pill, right? All races combined in one man, that's just like 99 summer jam. I'm like the feeling of a millionaire spending 100 grand. A millionaire is a millionaire, so 100 grand has now become what someone who has $100 would look at $10 like, is how a millionaire would look at 100 grand. That's, spend that shit then, go on regular. He just has so many references to like, people look at me like everyday life. Like people listen to me like everyday life. And that really applies to this album too. That's so fucking tough that he said that shit in this album as well. Cause like I was saying before, I feel like this album had the most songs that are just everyday life type of songs. His songs are mottos, bro. Track 14 is called Kissing, but it's spaced out like K-I-S-S-I-N-G.
K-I-S-S-I-N-G.
Come on. Is this like the third love song? He's got a couple love songs on here, man. He's big time now, bro. He's got to speak to both demographics, men and women, bro. He's got to have some song for the ladies on here too. Come on then. Let's go.
Like this.
Bougie. First date, the first date, crushed grapes, we ate lobster and steak. Bougie.
I wanna dig that. Did I did that. Put it way up where her ribs at. My future kids at. You held out for 2 weeks. Longer than each other ass. You precious. More precious than lost treasure. Matter of fact, I'm kinda hoping we can stay together. See you dressed up in white, face covered in veil. Do I hear wedding bells? My dog's throwing right. Then it's the day that your father give you away. To a real man, I gently put the ring.
My dog's throwing rice, painting the wedding hall. Everyone's in the chairs, both families on either side, wedding bells. My dog's throwing rice, the best man, a real man to gently put that ring on your hand. Driving on the plates, bro. Movie. When they drive off, they have just married on like the sign at the back windshield, or they would be on the plates driving off in a Rolls Royce, just married on the plates. Down to the details, bro.
Won't stop till you tell me too beautiful. Deeper and harder, love laying new with you. Running my fingers through your hair. It's like days can go by while I'm with you and I won't even care. We've been with young dudes, old guys, Hindus, Popeyes, Colombians who cut pies, but none of them can touch knives.
Why is it like that? Popeyes, Poppies.
Guys, Hindus, Popeyes, Colombians who cut pies, but none of them. To one day she decided to flip. There was nothing I could do about it. Like she the boss and shit. Started talking, it's the boss and shit.
Damn.
Half my rib, half my crib, half my cake, half
damn.
My
damn.
Swing on the guard, had to dip that. Yo, push on the bag, lift the leg, had to rip that. All she wanted was rough sex with a slick
One day she decided to flip, divorce, wanted to take half of everything. Nas said, you can't get that. Try to swing on the God, refers to himself as the God. Had to dip that, yo, push on the bed. Lift up. Motherfucker's a dog, bruh. She tried to swing at him, dipped, push on the bed, and started getting active. Is this a perspective song or who is he talking about? Y'all let me know if y'all know who he's talking about in this song. Because the whole song was about the women that he marries, the women that he wants to be with for the rest of his life. So y'all let me know who he's talking about, if he's talking about someone specific. Damn, this shit is so funny. Track 15 is called Money Is My Bitch. And just knowing how Nas, you know how there's always more than one meaning to shit, right? It's very fitting that Money Is My Bitch is the next song after K-I-S-S-I-N-G, based on the context of what he was talking about. I almost want to retract my statement. I show who he's talking about. He might still be talking about someone, but looking at what this song is called and seeing like the first few lines of the intro, boom. Looks like I know who he was talking about. The hoe turned me out, green eyes, had a crush on her. At this time, $100 bills was green. So green eyes, had a crush on her. You know what's so crazy is the motherfuckers who don't understand like the figurative language and don't understand the deep, like the layers to rap, really gonna look at this song and think that he's talking about a girl. Like this is a continuation of the girl that he married or something. Bro, this is talking about money, bro. Wait, she left them other dudes cold. When I bagged her upright, because you got to get the bag, right? You got to money bags, bro. But you bag a chick, like, watch how he do this shit now. Watch how he go crazy. Make a whole song talking about a girl the entire time, but talking about money the entire time at the same time. Watch how he wild out. Yeah, watch Nas do his Nas shit, bro. Keep me jig, glorifying medallions. Got me in clothes, made by attire. Feed me lobster and scallions. Watching the pap on my bed. Got me in clothes made by Italians, feed me lobster and scallions. Like the shorty is a rich one, so she taking care of him. But it's the money though. The money make it so he can afford the Italians. He can afford the lobster and scallions. Watching her pile on my bed, like the money stacks and piles. But like, lay on my bed, like, bro. She got me pussy whipped. He's in a trance, like. I like that too. I keep you in my pocket, cause like when you got a girl that you speak to. They had like the fucking the flips back in the day, the phones. You keep the number, keep it in your pocket. But you keep money in your pocket though. Like, watch how we do this shit, bro. I'm telling you, watch how we do this shit. I keep you in my pocket, it's so much of you, I share you and speak to you in private. You got me carrots on my wrist. I'm a savage for your kiss, embarrassed when I'm not with you. Before I got to my life, I say was mediocre, breaking things, swinging all night long, feeling the stroke. You seeing niggas with you, I wasn't happy. Wanted to stick them up to get you, heard you calling for daddy. And gladly, I take you as my lawfully wedded wife. Never divorce me, I promise to treat you right. Keep you satisfied, never lie, help you grow. Keep you satisfied, never lie, help you grow. Help the money expand, but help you, in the perspective of a woman, help her become a better woman. Like, sell my soul to you. What do I owe to you? My cars, my house, my flow to you. Screw you before you. Real niggas said I was cool. Now I got you, they envy me, cause I'm with you. Not one touch for you, my guns, but you always said in God we trust. It's hard enough to keep counting on you. You cheat with government. You always said in, oh, Come on, bro. That shit say it? What that shit say right there? What the fuck? Come on, bro. That shit wasn't even planned, bro. In God we trust. In God we trust. What that fucking shit say? But God's son. Nas is God's son. And Nas... Come on, bro. Your wife gonna trust. She gonna trust her man. She gonna always trust her man. In God's son. Like, Nas is God's son. So in God we trust. But the... Telling you, bro.
You see the government dogs got the IRS pounding on you. I think I liked you better when you were illegal, but you had to get...
You cheat with government thugs, got the IRS pounding on you? Like, the IRS is knocking doors like taxes, right? But like, pounding is like fucking, bro, like fuck, man. Fuck.
Stick you in ATMs, limited cash quick. Said you give me luxury when I asked it. Fuck me, I gave you back shots in your assets. Promise happiness, but really did nothing for me.
Money grow on trees? Oh my god. Just like that, we on the last track. Track 16, the final track, is called Undying Love. Bro, these albums pass so fast. That's how you know he's keeping me so entertained, bro. Like, it's so much to pay attention to with the Nas album. I never fall out of, like, my attention span. I'm in such a flow state when I listen to these shits, bro. But yeah, we on the last track now. Track 16 is called Undying Love. We gonna wrap this shit up and then I'm gonna give my final thoughts. And that's gonna be that. That's gonna be chapter 3, man. Let's go.
Pacino life, G-O, casino, dice in the garage, Vegas strip, neon lights, gamblers, puffers, cigars, couples and stars, flashing cameras, dealers, shuffling cards, spent the weekend, already miss New York and it's odd. Cause I'm the first to say it got too many hustlers and rob. I'm ducking up bitches in the club, clucking, telling my wife who I was dancing. Flew back Monday evening from the bottom where the sun was beaming to the concrete jungle of cement. Limousines from LaGuardia Airport. Sleeping, told my dog's peace, kept it moving. I was beat when got to my crib. Where the hell my keys went? Ringing the bell, heard a yell but wasn't sure. Dropped my luggage to the ground, put my ear to the door. Slow music, H-Town, no, that's down low. My babies, drop Mercedes, is parked. I creep around, yo, to the back. She must be inside and can't hear. Probably shocked it was unlocked. When I walked in, I smelled incense. Chased by a weed aroma. Empty canisters and lipstick marks on like 3 empty Coronas. A pair of blue jeans on the carpet.
Oh, no. Oh, shit. He got the feeling from Vegas. He was in Vegas, but he was already feeling like something's not right. New York just feel more at home. Came back to New York and look what he fucking walked into.
Something swinging on the ceiling fan. I stopped it, swinging slower and slower. On the last swing I saw it was a G-string and heard laughing. Thought about my 9-side block, but something maybe disregarded. Bedroom door opened the crack. See wife laying with some nigga mumbling shit. He had one hand on her ass and she was rubbing his dick. Toasting wine glasses, cherry scented candles was lit.
Jeez.
Couldn't handle the shit. Searching for words, I found none. Without a sound, I left the house with a sick smile and took my gun. Now I'm out bugging, wilding. What I'm going through? Call my man horse, meet me outside. I'm coming through.
Undying love, crazy.
I thought you needed me. Did you believe in me? With horse show, the look on my face was mad lost. I ain't know whether to cry, just try to laugh it off. Son, you home early. They wiped you out that quick. I said, nah, I showed them the plastic with 9 in the clip. Hopped in the whip, popped in the disc, press play. To the Grand Central from the Bandwick Expressway. I said,
now we gonna handle it.
Guess in a million years, what I just saw happening probably still is. They ain't seen me, I ducked and I slid. I'ma grab shorty, I need you to grab the nigga for me. Just when I thought I found love, she shitted on me. Shopped in Vegas, a present for our engagement. 20 G's on the ring.
Damn, oh my god. Shopped in Vegas, a present for our engagement. 20 G's on a ring I would have hit her today with. He was gonna propose. And look what he walked into. G-string on the fan is crazy. That's, man, the disrespect in his heart must be just unmatchable right now.
My surprise couldn't match the one she had for me. We pulled up, he was walking.
Yeah, really? My surprise couldn't match the surprise she had for me.
We pulled up, he was walking out the house backwardly. Parked in the back of my house, they couldn't see us. Ran to the side of my house, cocked the heater.
Yeah.
Walked to the front when I talked, he had jumped, bitch. Tried to slam the door shut, got caught in horse foot. Shot the Spanish kid in the
say goodbye to your undercover friend. One between the eyes, she died. My mistake must have held the gat too tight. Pointed at her face, her sirens. I guess we going out like kamikaze. We surrounded, red lights flashing. Who's inside? Came out of bullhorn. I'm contemplating suicide. Horse asked me for the match. He gave me that one love, cock the strap. Then he ran out the back, met on the floor near my dead girl. Put her in my arms, pulled the ring out my pocket. I was
wow.
Put her on a ring finger.
Oh my God.
And started praying to Muhammad and Allah, the most beneficial through you. All things are possible. I know you're listening. I never meant for this to happen. I never dreamed this would be my fate. Such a grotesque murder scene on
oh my God.
Same time the cops busted and kissed my lady. Her blood on my lips. I said amen. Put the nine to my
oh my God. This shit is insane. Okay, whoever recommended this shit, I believe they left comments too. They said this one had elite storytelling. Round of applause for you. This shit is insane. What a way to end the album. Oh my God. Him and Horse, he shot his lady between his eyes. Now the cops are surrounding the building. Horse went out the back. Shots is firing. He put the ring on his dead woman's finger. So at least he got done what he wanted to do. Kissed her lips, blood on his.
Put the nine to my head, pulled the hammer, held it close, squeezed the toe, said to her, now under God, we elope.
Oh my God. Now under God, we elope? Because she's dead, and then he squeezed the toast, he shoots himself. To elope is to run away, but they run away to heaven together. Oh my God. Insane. I got nothing to say, but wow. I can't speak other words, but wow. I'm going to say this completely transparently. It was written is like here, right? It was written is like here. This album, I Am, is like there. And Illmatic is like right there. Like right on top. But it might just take a couple more listens and for me to understand a couple more bars for this to even be better than Illmatic for me. And that might be a crazy take. I might have to re-listen to all the albums a couple more times. Of course, I'm new to this shit, right? But like, off the first listen, this album was amazing. I say that about every album, but like, this album just, it was all highs. It was just highs. There was no lows at all. No, I really love this album. I'm gonna have to get a vinyl of this shit. I'm gonna have to get a vinyl of this shit for sure. Adding this shit to my wall. My review is perfection, honestly. So, as we know, we previously mentioned in the beginning of this video, in Illmatic, he started off as a kid, young, right? And that makes sense why he's talking strictly about his hood. Because when you're a kid, you're young, you're not really moving around, exploring, right? Then he comes up a little bit, and then it was written, he's a man now. Now he's going around a little bit more. He's traveling a little bit more. And then now in this album, I Am, he's a king. He's elevated even further. Now he's really Hollywood with it. Now he's going traveling all over the place. He has enough power behind his voice that he can speak to the Congress and to the White House. Or at least he feels audacious enough to do so. You know, he's got the money, the power, the respect that he's been talking about since Illmatic and It Was Written. This song, Undying Love, has me shook, bro. It's just all about it, right? Like, it's the message, the story. But the story wouldn't hit me if his storytelling wasn't as elite as it is. Nas is quickly growing to become one of my favorite rappers, bro. Like, from this old era. I have to separate it from newer music, right? Because it's just different. It's just not the same at all. Like, newer music is so different than old music. I can't even compare them because it's just not comparable. But like, in terms of old, like the older age rappers, like the Jay-Z's, the Nas's, the, you know, the MF Dooms, the Outkast, in this era of like listening to these type of rappers, Nas is quickly growing to become my favorite of all of them. And it's just because he's just so good at what he does. Like, he's the king of this rap shit. I mean, he said it and proved it with this album. Now that I'm understanding the meaning behind these artworks, it's like an evolution. I'm so excited just to even see what chapter he's going to be in next in Nostradamus. If it continues the story, who knows? I mean, shit, he just killed himself at the end of this one. He might be like the Grim Reaper or something. He might be undead. He might be talking about afterlife or some shit. Other than what I've said, I'm speechless, honestly. Like, I don't have too much else to say. This album was perfection. This album was perfect. This was a perfect album, for real. Like, there was nothing, I have no complaints about this one. It could definitely grow to become my favorite Nas album out of the three I've listened to so far. It's right under Illmatic. It's right there. It can definitely grow to become my favorite one after a couple more listens. But yeah, man, I hope y'all enjoyed this reaction to I Am by Nas. If you did, you know what to do. I'm going to see y'all boys on Nostradamus, man. Peace.